I'm Anna Berry with John Wooley, someone you probably already know. Thank you, John, for joining me on Unscripted.
Glad to do it, Anna.
So, writer, you're an entertainment writer, an author of books, an editor, and an extreme movie buff. What do you not do, John?
Oh, just it's just jack of all trades, master of none. You know, I mean, this is stuff that most of the stuff that I make a living at now, I've loved since I was a kid.
You are a master of movies.
Oh, God bless you.
My goodness, you know so much. So, how many books have you written?
About 30 now. Actually, it's getting a little bit closer to 40 if you count the ones I've edited and co-written.
Right. And then you were the entertainment writer for Tulsa World
for 23 years. I started in 1980. Really, I was there for the last great days of the newspaper business, I think. I started in 83 and left in 2006.
So tell me a little bit about that. What did you write about? What were some of the favorite stories you covered?
Honestly, Anna, my claim to fame from my newspaper days is I was the first person to say that Garth Brooks was going to be a star in print. And he has always been nice enough to remember that. We've done a few things together since then, and he has always said, yes, that I was the one. And a lot of people still remember that.
Well, what led you to that prophecy?
I saw him at Tulsa City Limits nightclub. No longer had been
gone
for years. Yeah, but it was a big, big country nightclub for the touring acts. Mm-hmm. And he came through with his band, and it was just like nothing I'd ever seen. Mm. And I thought, this guy is going to be, and I said, I believe the word was something in the review that I wrote. I believe the term was, I think that Garth Brooks could be country music's next big thing.
And he has been, is, and I think always will be.
I think so too.
What do you do when you get home? What's the first thing you do?
Well, you know, I love to write. I mean, I've been blessed to be able to write for a living. I love to write. I love to read. I read a lot of 30s and 40s pulps. Mm-hmm. I have a little publishing house with my friend John McMahon in Tulsa, and we call Reverse Karma Press. And my grandmother, who was a writer, always told me that writing is the loneliest of all the professions. And she's right, but there's really nothing wrong with being alone.
There's nothing wrong with being alone, especially if you like your own company.
Yeah.
What's your process for writing? What do you do if you come up with writer's block?
I've never thankfully had any writer's block. I knew, Anna, that I was a professional writer the first day I wrote when I didn't want to.
Ah.
That's when you know.
And you're the first writer to be inducted into the Oklahoma Music Hall of
Fame.
That's
correct, because I wrote a lot. One of the things that I'm really proud of is I've been able to document Tulsa music and been able to talk to a lot of the guys. And really, rock and roll is a fairly new musical form. And so I was able to talk to a lot of the guys that started it back in the 50s. They were in the clubs with Leon Russell and David Gates and J.J. Cale and Jimmy Carstein and all of these other guys and Chuck Blackwell. They all started in the basically illegal Tulsa clubs. Mm-hmm. And I continue to love to write about those guys. And I wrote about a lot of them in my book, From the Blue Devils to Red Dirt, The Colors of Oklahoma Music.
I love that title. Well, let's talk some movies, because
sure.
I just was honored to be your co-host for this film.
Well, the honor
here at
goes both
which,
ways.
Where we are.
Yeah. Yeah, and you've done a wonderful job with it. I'm so happy to have you as my co-host. And
that's coming out in December here on RSU, so please stay tuned for that. John, always a pleasure. I've known you for 19 years,
19
our first
years.
Movie
I
together.
I cast you in a movie called Cafe Purgatory.
19 years
this
ago.
Jacket, I won this jacket because Cafe Purgatory was the Crowd Pleaser Award at Fort Worth Film Festival. I wear it proudly, and your very young self was a very big part of that.
Oh,
picture.
It was a joy, and a joy to work with you again 19 years
Thank
later.
Thank you, right,
all right
back at you.
Thank you, John. Thank you all for watching Unscripted.